Hello everyone, welcome to another Friday Live. I'm so happy to be here. Even though I am sort of flying by the seat of my pants here, I am not as prepared as I usually like to be before one of these live streams, but hopefully we're gonna have fun today. I have a very rough idea of what I'm going to be doing today. Extremely rough. In fact, I'm open to suggestions. let me check my phone here to make sure. We've got some comments coming through. I think I see comments. Let me see here. Yeah, I think we're good. Yeah, I'm just going to assume we're good. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of hellos. Hello from Virginia and Hawaii and Nova Scotia and Texas, Maryland, Quebec. Just lots. So like, welcome everyone. Okay. So, we're going to jump right into the crafting today because, you know, like I said, I don't have like a set plan today. So we're just going to go for it. These are the stamp sets that I thought I would use today. Mostly because I've been wanting to watercolor this background for ages since I designed it months and months and months ago. And I haven't had a chance. And so I thought, you know what, why not today? And then this one, because y'all, 2020 has just been a doozy. So many people, like even outside of the virus that will not be named, even outside of that, people are having a tough time, y'all. I don't understand. Like 2020 has just, whew. Yeah, it's a hard one out there, right? So, yeah. Anyway, so I thought, you know what? At this very moment, I don't have the need for a sympathy card, but I can read the writing on the wall. Like, I know I'm probably gonna need one. And that is when, like, when you don't need one, that's when you should make one, right? Because when you do need one, you're not in the right state of mind to like really be crafting, although it can be very therapeutic. So maybe that's just me, but okay. All right. All right. Little blip there. Got it right back on though. So I'm glad it's working. Yep. Amanda says 2020 is just a big punch in the gut. I would have to agree. I mean, personally, I've had a lot of good things happen, but overall, it's kind of sucked. So 2021 will only bring good things. Please, please, only good things. Okay, so we're gonna make an insurance card. We don't wanna have to use it, put it that way. All right, so I'm gonna turn off my little camera here because like I said, I didn't have a whole lot of time to prep. So I'm gonna be moving around my craft room a little bit, grabbing supplies, whatnot. So, but this is the All Leaves stamp set, or stamp, it's a 6x6 stamp. And it's from Simon, obviously. I'm going to be stamping it onto some, you know what? Only the best for a sympathy card. We're gonna use my all-time favorite watercolor paper, which I've only ever bought one pad of because it was so super expensive. I don't want to rebuy it. So, we're gonna use Saunders Waterford Cold Press, which it is the most luscious, creamy, thick, cottony paper. I mean, you all are gonna love it. I'm gonna take my mic off for a minute so I can go grab it. Here we go. I love this watercolor paper so much. Okay, and I'm gonna stand here. It's a little bit easier. Oh look, I already have a piece already cut out. We're not gonna waste any. Seriously, I save little bits. I can use this little tiny bit. I can do a color test on that, right? I don't ever wanna run out of this stuff. You know what, I haven't looked in quite a while if there are other sources to purchase this paper. There might be, and if that's the case, it might be a little cheaper now, but it's yeah, I hoard it. I don't want to let it go. All right, we're gonna back out a little bit, do a little stamping. You can see my laptop right here. All right. And I think I want to do some, oh, that's going to be a little too big. Okay, first let's measure this. It is just over 5 wide. Okay, so we'll just make, so if it's a, let's see, 4 1/4 to 5, that's 3/4 more. So 5, 6 1/4 is probably a good, if I'm going to do a A2 card. Let's do some quick math there. You know, I'm fairly convinced that the only reason they make art majors take math classes is so they can do measurements accurately. And even then, it's no guarantee. All right, so this is going to be a little bit bigger than my paper, but that's okay. I'm going to be taping it to a board anyway, so it doesn't matter as much. Oh, Patty, thank you for, oh, sorry, wrong one. Patty, the 1918 pandemic lasted over 2 years. You know, I was asking the other day, I was like, how long did the 1918 pandemic last? Because I was really curious. I'm like, they didn't have some big vaccine or anything. They just had to let it run its course. So maybe, I don't know, maybe that's our fate. All right, I'm gonna put that down. Lift. This is the one of the MISTI Creative Corners, by the way. It just helps me get that in the right spot. And where's my remote? Here we go. We're just going to zoom in a little bit. What? The paper is $29 on Amazon? Okay, y'all. Okay. I'm obviously live. I cannot go to Amazon and purchase the paper right this moment. So don't y'all get crazy and go and get it and then buy them all and then I can't get it. Please, please, wait, wait till I'm done. let me go buy it. Okay, so I'm going to use VersaMark Ink. I'm going to do, you know, I think if this is kind of like a fallish card, leaves and gold embossing powder would be gorgeous. So I'm going to do some gold embossing powder. Oh, someone says they also went to Amazon but saw it for $43. You know what? That's the price that I was seeing. So maybe, you know, Ellie found like a super secret sale link. I don't know. Okay, here we go. Now that I'm thinking about it, probably should have used my anti-static powder tool. But on the other hand, a lot of you, if you do embossing on watercolor paper, you may notice this. Watercolor paper is very, very dry. It doesn't like absorb things. So sometimes I don't need the anti-static powder tool, you know? Okay. All right, it didn't lift, it didn't move. So I'm gonna go ahead and stamp that again. The other thing I like about watercolor paper and stamping with the VersaMark is generally your stamps don't stick to it because it is so dry. Hope I'm not gonna regret stamping that twice. Shanna's asking if my cats get locked out when I go live. No, sometimes they wander through. But like usual, crispy stamp chamois every week. It's like a tradition at this point, right? Oh, Karin says 1916, lost both my great grandparents in it. My grandmother was 5. Oh my gosh. All right. Very sobering thought. Okay, cleaning off my stamp, just a quick little wipe off. And put that back on the clear sheet. All right, thankfully the VersaMark ink stays sticky for quite some time. So I have plenty of time to do my embossing. The $29 one has a $15 shipping fee. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And that might be why I hesitated ordering more, you know? I think I just might have to find maybe a local art store that carries it. I think that might be the best route. And you know, not really going out shopping right now, so that could be a problem. Okay, here we go. Oh my word. I love these leaves. These leaves are essentially a mixture of all the different leaves from my stamp sets that I've done for Simon over the years. I'm going to tap this over a trash can to get rid of any of the embossing powder that doesn't want to come off. And when I tap it on the back, it's always like a mess if I don't do it over my trash can. So there we go. That cleans up everything. I do not regret stamping it twice. That looks awesome, especially on watercolor paper. All right. Hits with my heat tool. I'm going to let it run, turning on my heat tool and letting it heat up, because I have not used this today at all. So it's going to be cold. And if I put it on my project right away, it's going to be heating up while I'm heating the paper, you know, and I don't need that. I want to prevent warping. So I'm going to let it kind of warm up off to the side. Oh, Anna Reyes asks what paper I'm talking about. Saunders Waterford Cold Press. Looks like so. It is the most luscious paper ever. I love it. I only use it for very special projects. And today I'm feeling it. So here we are. All right, letting it heat. Letting it heat up. All right, that might be long enough. And I'm also going to keep it moving around. There we go. Now it's started. Okay, as I was embossing this, I had a scary thought. Yeah, I'm like, this looks really smooth on this side. Did I put it on the wrong side of the paper? Oh no, I think I'm good. Okay. I was very concerned there for a moment. Yeah, I'm totally good. That's the correct side. Which, if some of you weren't aware, there is a like intended side for watercolor paper. I wouldn't say correct because you really can use both sides. But the intended side is usually the side that is up, facing up in the pad that you have. Generally, it's a little bit more textured than the back. So a reason why you might use the back on purpose is if you're going to be doing some stamping and then watercoloring, and you want your stamped image to be very crisp and the lines to be very fine. You might have trouble getting very crisp lines on the very textured side of the paper. So in that case, you might want to flip your paper over and stamp on the more smooth side. So that would be why. Okay. All right. I'm going to use a hardboard and tape this down. Ta-da. And that gold embossing powder is really pretty. That was Gilded embossing powder from Brutus Monroe, by the way. Krista is asking about storing my finished cards. You know, I don't have a good solution for that yet. Right now I kind of have shoe boxes and my cards are standing up like filing style with matching envelopes. And then I've only put them into a few different categories. I'm looking at them right now. I have one whole bin that's just Christmas winter because I've been doing my holiday card series forever. And unfortunately last year I never mailed out my Christmas cards. And what's bad is I addressed all the envelopes, but I didn't finish like writing messages inside. And then next thing I know, it's like February and I'm like, well, this is dumb. I'll just wait till next year. So I have Christmas. I have Just Because / Hello. Encouragement, which I include like sympathy cards in that as well. I have Miss You, Thank You, and Birthday. Those are the categories that I have because those are the kind of cards I send most of the time. If I'm going to be sending a different type of card, like maybe it's like a graduation card or I don't know, I can't think of anything specific like that. But if it was like a graduation card or something like that, I would probably just be making it one off like for that specific person. So I don't need to like store it, if that makes sense. All right. I'm going to ask you in the chat what type of watercolors you want today. Do you want Mijello Mission Gold, which is what I'm leaning toward, or What else could I try? I could do markers. That stuff I did with the Karin markers earlier this week. I think it was my video on Monday. Was it Monday? I could do that. So markers or paints, which one do you want? To wait for the chat to catch up a little bit. And you know what? I will get out both of those right now just in case, because it's unfortunate. I cleaned my craft room and so nothing's out and handy anymore. Everything's put away. And these watercolors are like buried, so I've got to get them out. Okay. All right, and my markers are out all the time, so I've got those. Okay. Paints, markers, paints, 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 markers. Oh, it looks like 50-50 right now on my end. Paints, markers, 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 paints. You know what? I think I'm going to go with markers because that's what most people are saying. I think it's more markers than paints. I think. Or you know what? Why don't I split this in half? I can do one with markers, one with paints. Seriously, why do I have to limit myself, right? I'm going to put on a little bit of tape separating the two. This is some really, really thin masking tape, which apparently is very sticky and doesn't want to tear. I haven't used this one before. Oh, that is very sticky. Let's hope it doesn't tear anything. All right, we will just go like so. And we'll do one with markers, one with paints. I think that's a good example or a good way to go about it. My MISTI magnet is running free. Go home, magnet. Go back in there. Okay, there we go. All right. We're going to start with the paints because that's what I have out. So here's my Mission Gold palette. Here's my swatches that I always use. I usually set these aside somewhere far away from the paint so they don't get splattered. And I'll be mixing some colors over here on the side. And now I'm very happy that even though I was not particularly prepared for today's live stream, that I did have the wherewithal and a little bit of time to go fill up my water bucket. Because not only did I need it for my chamois, I'm also going to need it for all this watercoloring. Right? Okay. Hi. I'm up here in the corner again. Okay, so which side do we want to start with? I think, in fact, I could make these different color schemes. I could have one be more like fall, autumn, and the other be more spring, summer. I don't think I'll do that though. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do, I'm bringing out this big mama brush. Remember when I said I cleaned my craft room? I found this brush and I was like, holy crap, I've had this brush since college. My original watercolor class, how many years ago was that? That was like 2004? Ugh, make a girl feel old. All right, but it's a really good brush for putting down just a whole layer of water. All right. Okay. And then, turning off my headshot because I'm not talking at your face anymore. What brush do I want to use? I kind of want to, you know what? I'm going to change it up. Have some brushes in another drawer. I don't use them as often anymore, but I have all these silver black velvet brushes and I'm like, dude, they're so nice. Why don't I use them more? I'm gonna use this number 8. Actually, I'm getting out a number 8 and a number 4. The thin blue tape. I got it on Amazon, I believe. All right, so I'm gonna get this wet again. Cause it's been sitting there a while I was finding my dang brushes. Okay. All right. I don't have a specific color scheme in mind. I'm just going to pick up colors off my palette. Like, this looks good. All right. And this green over here looks pretty good. So I'll just do that. Oh, I kind of like this reddish orange I've got on my palette up here. So let's bring in some of that. Ooh, and I'm going to need yellow, right? Like a bright golden yellow. So let's just bring that right up in here. These are going to dry back quite a bit. They won't be as bright and vibrant. I'm just picking up colors from my palette. You know what? Why don't we do this? Ta-da! Then I can zoom in a little bit and you guys can see my painting and my palette. All right. I'm going to bring more of this golden color in. Maybe make it a little bit orangey. Just right down here. Bring more of this brownish shade. And then I feel like I need that bright green again. Maybe it just comes right here. And then this other green. All right. I'm going to let that dry while I work on the marker side. I've got to grab all my markers. The stamp set I used is all leaves. It's a 6x6 stamp set from Simon. All right, I think I'm just gonna stand for this. All right, here's my little swatch chart of all my Karin markers. Someone asked me how I did this. I don't know what I used for my circle, but I just traced lines of circles and then put them on there. So I'm going to refer to this while I pick out some colors. And I just might end up with the same colors I used in my video a couple weeks ago because I just loved them so much. Okay. Ooh, and then I want a gold. Okay. So very fallish colors again. I'm going to turn this so that I can... I'm going to use that big, huge brush once again. And just wet this area. All right, and then I'm just gonna start, I'm gonna start dropping in color. And you know, I forgot to get a paper towel. I stamped the background stamp in VersaMark Ink and then heat embossed it with Gilded embossing powder from Brutus, Monroe. Yeah, was that what the question was? Okay. All right. I'm just going to like drop in some color over here. Then I can use my brush to kind of get this out. The colors on the marker side are going to be much more muted at first, I believe. All right. Add that red in. Come in and kind of get this moving. Bring in this blue right through here. Get those colors mixing a little bit. You know, I'm remembering why I loved this brush. Okay, I'm gonna bring the purple off in that corner. It just holds a lot of water. But it's not like it like soaks your paper. The brush, I mean. Okay, we're gonna grab this green. I think this is the olive color, right? Olive black. Let's bring that down right there. It does have a very black tinge to it, so I don't wanna add too much. And then, I'm missing one last color. Oh, cinnamon. Is really green. Is cinnamon usually like a greenish brown? strange name. All right. So we will come back to that later. I'm going to sop up some of this color up here. All right. Yeah, this is very streaky at the moment. I do like the variation in color, but we're going to speed this up with my heat tool. Now, I painted on top of heat embossing. So I don't want to leave my heat tool on any area too long because it would remelt the heat embossing powder and then I would lose the line definition. So I'm going to keep my heat tool moving. Okay, I think this area up here is not quite dry. I'm feeling it. The way you can tell if your paper is completely dry is if it feels cool to the touch. If it's cool to the touch, it means there's still some moisture in it. Letting it cool down from the heat tool. Yeah, I think they're dry. The reason I wanted it super dry is just because I don't want to get, you know, I don't know, I just always do it dry. Now that I think about it, I don't really have any particular reason right now. All right, I'm gonna move my marker box up here so I can sit in my chair again. Okay. Yeah, someone's commenting that the watercolor side is coming through much better. I think that's because the color was very saturated when I put it down. As I start doing some more defined leaf painting, I think that might change a little bit. Okay, we're going to go back to the markers. You know what? I'm going to zoom in so you guys can see what I'm doing. I know some people want to see my paint palette, but that's really hard to get on camera and then also have it zoomed in as well. You know, like it's just hard. I don't know if that's even possible. Okay. I've switched to my size 4 brush. And I'm just going to pick up a little bit of color. And I may basically just want to define some of these shapes so that it's a little bit easier to read as a separate leaf, you know? All right. I'm going to grab my gold up here. And I think I'll just start dropping the gold in some different spots. And I love how you can kind of move it out from where you have it most concentrated when you start painting. I think I'm going to add like definitely more green down here. Just add lots of concentrated green at the base of these leaves, get my brush wet, and just sort of spread that out. This is just going to start defining the leaf shapes. This is very, very similar to what I showed in Monday's video, using the markers as well. All right, I'm gonna mix up another green for me to use. And I think I'll come in here, just add a little bit of this green. The thing that I like about starting with a layer of color is you don't have to worry about all the the space in between, all the negative space. You can just paint the shapes and be done. You know, like all of this around here and the negative spaces in between the leaves. This paper, you guys. Oh my word. I love it so much. Okay. I think I want one of these like maple leaves over here to be really red. Like a nice brick red. So I'm mixing that color, dark reddish brown. I'll just start to put that right here, wetting my brush to sort of dilute the color a little bit. Oh, I love how that looks. Oh, thank you, crafting with Slavy, maybe? Slavy? I'm not sure. I think I need this stamp set. Either way, I'm going to try this technique. Beautiful. Yes, it's one of my favorite. I do it every once in a while. I kind of go through a phase, you know, every little bit. And stamp sets like this are just so wonderful for it. Okay, I think I'll do... got kind of a yellowy color. I think I'll... actually, I kind of want it to be like a yellowy orange, so I'll change that a little bit. This definitely has some fall vibes, right? All of you who are watching live, holiday card series starts next week. I'm trying to decide if I want the holiday card series to go up all the way until the 23rd of December, or if I want it to end on the 21st. And that determines if I'm going to start the series this coming up Monday or Wednesday. So let me know in the chat, like, which, do you want it to go all the way up till the 23rd, or would having it end a little bit earlier be better? I'm open to both. I'm not sold on either. Or like, you know, married to it, I guess. Okay. All right, someone says 23rd. Okay. I think I want to do kind of an orange up here too. So, actually, I don't want to lose that really pretty green to yellow right here. Is the Mijello paint on the higher end quality? Yes, I think it's really high quality. 23rd, 21st. You know what? It seems like everyone's kind of half and half so far. Like, and the 21st. You know, I think people get busy right up to Christmas, even in this year, which is just bizarre. I think people will be getting pretty busy. Adding more of this red over here. Oh no, I'm getting the hiccups. I love how that leaf is turning out. All right, there's one little like spot that's really bugging me. I'm gonna try to come in and kind of soften that out so it doesn't look like such a mistake. That helped. Okay. I think I'll grab a green shade and add it up here. More saying 21st. Okay, all right, 21st. So holiday card series starts Monday. I guess that's my answer, right? All right, I'm just going to add a little bit of a green up here and spread it out to the edge of that leaf. There we go. think I need like another yellow shade down here. So I'm going to do that yellow color. Looks a little bit brownish. Maybe I'll add a little more of a gold shade to that. Hey, Dana. My friend Dana just popped in. Dana, since you're just joining us, I will catch you up. We're doing regular watercolor on this half, and then we're doing marker up here. So I'll get back up to that one in just a little bit here. All right. Going to grab some more green, and I think I want to do this leaf right here, just in a pretty intense green. And maybe that not as intense green on this leaf. All right, I'm gonna bring a little of that green over here. All right, I think I got all the leaves. Here we go. Thanks, Dana. All right, I'm gonna swap this. So that's where that one stands. I'm not loving this all right here. I think maybe it needs more of that dark red shade, maybe at the base of the leaves. I thought I was done with this section, but I'm gonna come back and just I just love this red up here, you know? Oh, so pretty. I've been going up to cabin up in like forested area, and the leaves are just gorgeous up there, and they have like full on red bushes of leaves, and it's just so pretty. Oh, I forgot this leaf right here. I'm glad I looked. Okay. Yeah, I think I needed that red. Totally. Kind of a nice brick red. I'm gonna spread this out a little more. It's looking a little crazy. All right. So very fall colors on this one. This one down here is a little more like summer, I think. We'll see. They're a little psychedelic. All right, once again, that is the watercolor side. Now we're going to go to the marker side. All right, so let's see. I'm going to add some of this purple right down here. I think over that red area, it'll just be gorgeous. Adding that purple just at the base of the leaves. Bringing in a clean, damp brush. And then just extending that color. All right. Trying to determine what leaf this is. I think that is a different leaf. But I'll finish the purple on these little spots. Okay. And I want to bring purple in somewhere else, but I don't necessarily want it over here. I think I'll do mostly blue over here. So I think there's this leaf back here. It's actually the other half of that one up there. But I'm gonna go ahead and just add the purple at that base. The thing that's interesting about the markers versus the watercolors is the markers, I think, layer really well and they keep their vibrancy in just an interesting way. They're not as light fast, unfortunately, but I really do like the look of them. All right, let's do some of the yellow. And I'm gonna go ahead, let's see, you know what? I kinda wanna add an orange to this. You know, like I want orange marker. So, gotta get out my markers again. And I'm gonna just grab an orange. Kind of a yellowy orange, color amber. And I'm going to put it at the base of this leaf right here. And then I can start spreading it out. Okay, here we go. I'm going to go back to that black olive shade that I was using earlier, and I'm going to add that to the bottom of these leaves for this little stem with leaves. It's kind of a really interesting color palette here, but I'm not hating it. All right. You know what? I realize I don't even have an actual green, which I think it needs. So I'm grabbing olive green, which kind of makes sense with the olive black. Oh yeah, that's what I needed. Just needed a little green in there. In fact, I think I'll have these be green also, but just a little bit. I don't want it to like overtake the color that's underneath. And I like the sort of mix of color I'm getting with these layered. I just saw someone's comment saying they don't see much olive in my olive black color. You know what it is? It's like, it's just like a soft black. I wouldn't even call it like an olive black. It's more of just a soft black. Okay. All right, so there's the green. I love this leaf right here. I kind of want it in that red color. I don't want to do purple. I'm just going to do it in the red. Just kind of get a good base of color there. Because it's a maple leaf, and I just think of like maple leaves in the fall, turning the most beautiful colors. And I love that this red layered over the blue sort of turns it purple. I think it's really pretty. The more I think about it, I think I should have put a lighter layer of color on the paint side initially, because I think that would have given me more opportunity to layer color on top. But these just really are gorgeous and vibrant. Okay, I'm gonna add orange. I think I'll do orange down here, because I want it to like mimic that top corner. This orange color really doesn't want to move, does it? Okay. Alrighty. I think I'm going to go back to that green shade and I'm going to do it all up through here. The green will layer really beautifully on top of that blue in the background. Oh, that looks really pretty. All right, and I think I want like a little bit of a different color of green for right here. So I'm going to use lime green, which seems kind of bright. I'm hoping it's not too in your face bright. Oh, I think it's gonna be great. I think these markers in general, could this be the color palette I've chosen, just are a little brighter overall. They have a lot of just brightness to them, you know what I'm saying? All right, I'm gonna bring this red shade down here at the bottom. There's not much of this leaf showing. So, but I think it'd be really pretty just to bring in that red down here at the bottom. There we go. All right, I mostly just have this leaf, this one right here, and then these up in here. I think I'm gonna do the blue. I haven't really done the blue much, and I think it will layer really well on top of that purple. So I'm gonna do blue at the base of these leaves. And then start to spread that out. It's just gonna intensify the purple shade that it's got going. I don't know that there are leaves in nature that really look like this, but that's okay. I love this. I'm right on top. What color is this? Sapphire blue. Definitely getting more color on this side, but that's also because I'm choosing more color. I added blue. I've got a purple. I didn't do that on the watercolor side. So don't fault the watercolor. I think it would be a little different no matter what. All right, I'm gonna do the blue over here too. So I feel like it needs that. Oh yeah, and then you can really see the color spread. I like that, especially next to the orange. All right, I think this one right here, I'm gonna go back to that bright green because it needs a friend. It needs something else that's that same bright green shade. I'll just spread this out a little. It browned up the one end that was over the red. Totally okay with that. All right. Got a few little leaves right here. Oh, I think that was actually background, but that's okay. And then there's this spot right up here. I think I will do a little bit of that olive black just because it hasn't been used anywhere else except down at the bottom. Okay. And there's just like a little hint of a leaf right here. Okay, definite difference between these two, especially in the color palette and just the brightness, you know, like here's the difference. It's the color. A lot of it is the color, I think. Debba Doobie is asking about granulated colors. You know what? Mission Gold doesn't have any, I don't think, which is probably why I love it so much, because I really don't like granulation. So that's probably what, you know, I'm loving the like deep, intense color I'm getting in some of these areas. And I wish it was like that up here. So I'm going to swap this around and I'm going to try to add some deeper like variation in color. I'm not gonna get as bright colors because I've already got kind of a very muted palette going, but. I think it would only make it look even better. See how just adding a little bit of a darker area, just that contrast is just bringing this to life, similar to what happened up here. And it's these darker areas that I'm missing. Like right now, they're all kind of the same darkness, you know? And so I'm gonna add more contrast down here so that I can get some more of that contrast. All right, let's see here. Yeah, I think it definitely needed like just a little extra attention to get these shapes to really pop. All right, I think I'm going to use that same green I've mixed up just down here. Okay. I think I need to define these leaves more. So, let's see, how do I want to do this? I also need to define these up here, but while I've still got that darker green, I'm going to go ahead and just get these painted. Okay, I think that's much better. I'm gonna darken up the same red that I did over here. Okay. And then, let's see, what do I wanna do? I think I'm gonna bring in like a deep orange, but I will hit that with some brown to deepen it. And let me get this right here. You know what? I really like how that color is going. So I'm going to do that right up here. It's a nice, rich brown shade. I really love that. All right, I'm losing definition right in here. I might just go ahead and go in with that same green color that I was using before because I'm really loving it. So I'm just gonna come in with this green. You know what I'm noticing? Like the green, this dark green on top of the other areas really moves well, but when it's over top of this brown, it just really doesn't want to move. Okay. All right. Needed to find this leaf up here. Once again, I'm going to go into that dark green. It's looking real dark, but I'll spread that out. Okay. Anyway, I like how that looks. Okay. Want to get this one right in here. Mixing up a golden orange shade. And going to drop it in here. I don't know if it's really going to help define the leaf more or not, but it was looking a little drab compared to everywhere else. There's not much of a color difference there either, so I'm going to, let's see, got to mix up a darker brown to put on this leaf. Trying to save it. All right, and I think I'm losing some of this intensity that I loved over here. So I'm going to come in and just add another layer. It's also going to make it a little more red. Okay. I love that so much more now. All right. I'm going to hit this with my heat tool. This one up here is mostly dry. This one's not because I just finished it, but I'm just going to speed dry it. Okay, so I think for the paint side, I want some gold paint splatters, but I don't want it on this side. I love how this is so clean. So I'm gonna leave that. Hold on, I gotta get my paints out of the way here. I'm gonna leave this up here and I'm gonna do some fine tech paint splatter down here, which means I have to dig out my paints. Once again, to my watercolor drawer, find my fine tech. All right. Here's my fine tech palette. And I'm going to pick a gold that is most similar to the embossing powder, which I think is probably this one. All right. Going to take a paper towel and protect this side while I paint splatter on the other side. Hold on, I gotta close up some drawers so I can get out an acrylic block because I do like to splatter off the edge of an acrylic block. I think I just have more control that way. Getting my paint ready. All right, I'm just gonna paint the edge of this block. This brush isn't very big, so I'm not getting a whole lot of paint, but that's okay. We don't have a huge area to paint splatter. It's a little more on the smaller side. All right, so then I can just, actually, you know what? I'm gonna use a bigger brush because I want bigger paint splatters than that. And the size of your brush will determine how big your paint splatters are. Okay. I just think it's so fun to have some gold paint splatters. Okay. Cleaning off my block. All right, let's dry this side and then I'll peel off all the tape. let's peel this off and get this tape started. All right. You know what? Like, the rainbow loving part of me is totally digging the marker side more than the paint side, but I think it's just because of the colors I chose, you know? Looks almost psychedelic. Right. Let's trim these down. I don't want to lose any of the painting, so I'm going to try to trim these as close as possible, but still squaring them up. In fact, if I wanted to, I probably could find a die that's similar. Hold on, let's zoom out here so you're not staring at just the paper trimmer. All right. Get that one over just a little more. Okay. All righty. Oh, it's so pretty just on its own. Okay. Ooh, I love that. Okay. I think for, let's see here. Here's an A2 size of paper. Ooh, that's going to be really pretty. See all the gold on that? But a 5x7, I just have to grab a 5x7 card I've already made. Ooh, that would be really pretty in a 5x7 as well. Okay. I think I'm going to do... You know what? I'm going to do one for A2 and one 5x7. So I think I'll do the marker one on a 5x7 card base. So that one will go right in the center. Ta-da! And then for the other one, I'm gonna do maybe a craft card base. I think that could be really pretty. It's kind of like rustic a little bit. All right, where's my scoring board? Actually, you know what? It's all kind of the same tone. I don't think I want to do that. Maybe I'll do black. I'm going to do black 5x7. Ooh, that's dramatic. Although these are going to be sympathy cards, remember? I want it to be a little brighter. So we'll do another white one. Here we are. All right. All right, now I've got to figure out what I'm doing with my sentiments. If you remember, I wanted to use this stamp set, which is the Sympathy Greetings Mix from Simon. And I really don't want to cover up these backgrounds because I love them so much. Okay, have an idea. Why don't I do this with Sympathy and it can go right across the bottom? I think that would be great. It wouldn't cover up too much. I'll put it on vellum, maybe two layers of vellum so I can glue it down. I think that's a good idea. And I'll heat emboss it. All right. Put these to the side. Got all my markers over here. Need to put my markers off to the side too so that they're out of the way. Then I can get my MISTI out. All right, I'm grabbing some vellum. Which I will need to trim down really quickly. I generally cut it to an A2 size just because it's a little easier to work with. All right. With Sympathy stamp. Just put that right at the bottom. And now I'm going to use my anti-static powder tool because embossing powder tends to stick to vellum, at least I've noticed. VersaMark. I don't want to balloon out this type, so I'm being very gentle as I apply it, or as I press the stamp down. And I'm going to go ahead and just turn this and stamp the other end as well while it's mounted. And then I don't have to clean off my stamp or anything since I'm doing two of these cards. Okay. Going back to Brutus Monroe Gilded Embossing Powder. I realized I didn't powder one of these ends, so hopefully it'll still be okay. You can see like the bottom line is a little thicker. I think it'll be okay. Just putting my stamp back away. All right, I'm going to rough cut these. And see how much it would cover up the... Okay, I think I could apply enough glue on that to, you know, just behind the letter so that the glue isn't showing as much. I also need to adhere these to my card before I do all this gluing. Okay, so that would just go right over the top. Oh, I love that. In fact, I could even do a couple other hearts or something, but I think the leaves are imagery enough. I don't think I need additional imagery. There's a part of me that's tempted to add gold embossing around the edge of the painting, but I think I will refrain. I will keep it simple. Okay, to get out my big mama roll of tape. And apply a generous amount of foam tape. I'm going to go ahead and do foam on both of these while I can, since I've got my foam tape out. Oh, I think I might have torn off the perfect amount of foam tape, which rarely happens. Oh, I was so close. Just that little bit left. That's okay. I'll use it. Okay. You guys are so chatty. I love it. And I love that there's so many of you answering each other's questions. And okay, I'm trying to decide which direction. I think I like this one more. All right. Coming over for this one. This way. I want this way. There's a lot of this brown down here, and I think the greeting will kind of break it up a little. Okay. So these are going to go down at the bottom. Or I guess I could even like have it at the top or in the middle. I think I'm going to have it right there. All right, I'm going to use some Gina K Connect glue. And what I'm going to do is try to hide it behind the embossing. So I'm going to apply my little dots of glue only behind the gold embossing. Let me zoom in so you kind of see what I'm doing here. All right, so I'm just, this glue is blobbing out. Having to dab it off. Okay. Come on, glue. I don't know if I'll be able to get such small amounts of glue because it keeps blobbing out on me. Oh, hello. I don't need the corners. They're going to be hanging off. Okay. Sometimes if you go like right behind, like in the interior of a letter, that works. I don't know how successful I'm going to be with this, but that's okay. All right, we just need enough glue that it'll stick. And it dries clear too, so that helps. Okay, now for this other one. Getting kind of blobs of glue, but whatever. Doesn't really show up on the other one, so I'm hopeful this one will be okay. Okay. Normally I would just put adhesive completely on the entire surface. I guess I really could have. Okay. All right, let's zoom out so you can see the finished cards. Oh, I love how those turned out. They turned out so good. You know, sometimes you're just not sure where you're going with whatever you're working on, but I love how this turned out. I hope you guys are enjoying it today too. All right, hi. So I think overall, like, what speaks to my soul is this really bright one, but I do really love this one too. It's a little bit more sedated, so maybe like for a sympathy card, it might be a little bit more some people's speed, but I love both. Let me know in the comments, which do you prefer? Do you prefer the marker or do you like the paint? Because I could go either way, really. Looking at the comments. Thank you all. I'm so glad you guys like how it turned out. I'm really pleased with it as well. All right. Well, it's about that time when I'm going to like close out the live stream. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you guys have any questions, let's put those in real quick. And I'll see if I can get them. I'm going to wait a minute. There's always a delay with the comments, you guys. If you've been watching me, you know that I've said it multiple times. There's a delay with the comments. I don't see them right away. All right. If you're in the U.S., just a reminder to vote. Vote early. Get out there. You know, make your voice known. Times are weird. Like I said at the beginning of this live stream. Someone asked about of the Karin markers, which set to invest in. I unfortunately, most of the time, am like a full set syndrome lady. Like, just go for all of them. So I would say the 60 set. That's what I've had since the beginning. And I really use a lot of the colors. I think there's only a few that I haven't used. So I think it's worth it. Let's see. The markers are on the pricier side. They are an investment, but mine have lasted a really long time. And I love that you can see the liquid in the marker. Okay, let's see. Andrea's asking, are you doing more live streams after today? Because I am starting up the holiday card series next week. You know, I was really torn because I love these lives every Friday. But I also know that a lot of people tune in for the holiday card series and they just watch the cards. They don't want any of the extraness, all the that would come with a live stream. So I'm thinking of either like, well, there's a few different options, actually. There's probably three options. And maybe you guys can weigh in on which one you like. Oh, are people asking about my t-shirt? Someone said, nevertheless, you present. Yeah, mm-hmm. So three scenarios. Let me know which one you like. The first is no lives, just holiday card series, normal videos, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, up until Christmas or nearly Christmas. Option two is live streams on Friday, and they are just incorporated into the holiday card series. People can just watch the live stream. It's all good. So like, since I'm starting day one of the holiday card series on Monday, next Friday would be day three of the holiday card series. That is option two. Option three is sort of a mixture of both, which would be you'd have the live stream on Friday, which would, you know, day three of the holiday card series. And then on Saturday, there would be an upload of the live stream edited down to just the card making segment, like a regular video. You would probably just see me like moving my hands like I'm chatting with people, but it would have a voiceover. So it would be a condensed version of the cards shown the previous day during the live. So let me know. So option one, no lives. Option two, lives only. Or option three, lives plus condensed version. Let me know. So, yeah, the lives are good. But the lives would be also holiday card series. I don't think I have enough time to do like three regular videos plus a live. I think that's a lot. First is a very bad idea. Everyone's like, we don't want no lives. That's too funny. Option two, just cards. Option three, option two, we like the lives. You know, and I really like just the lives. I think that's fun. People can tune in or whatever. Okay, I'm seeing some option three. Both option three, two or three. I'm not seeing as many for one. People are saying not one. So you don't want to lose the lives. Okay, well, whatever I do, I will keep the lives. We'll see. It might be too much of a challenge to edit down the live stream content. because I just approach the card making a little bit differently. So we'll see. Not losing the lives. I'll be back next Friday, noon Mountain Time. It will be Holiday Card Series Day 3. So don't forget to tune in for Days 1 and 2. You don't want to miss out. All right. Thank you guys for joining me today. I really love how these two cards turned out. I kind of surprised myself. I wasn't sure where it was going. I was not prepared today. So, but it's fun. I love having kind of like this journey with all of you, and you guys are weighing in and giving me some tips and things like that. It's been great. All right. I'm going to call it. I've got to go have lunch. So yeah, it's 1:30 here. I haven't had anything since early this morning, 7:30 for breakfast. So I am famished. So have a lovely day. Have a lovely weekend. I will see you guys on Monday for the first day of the Holiday Card Series. I hope you tune in.